In principle, a list ranking is a scan. The essential problem is this data structure. It just has a single entry point, which is the head. And the interface, as we've defined it, leaves no option to get other elements of the list without traversing them one by one. Now, put another way, I could ask you the question, what made scans on arrays easier? Essentially, it was random access. So what you need to do is you need to take this list representation and turn it on its head, so to speak. Let's imagine a different way to represent a linked list based on what I'll call an array pool. And this representation has two features. First, we'll find a way to put the values in an array. And secondly, we'll replace the concept of a pointer, or a next pointer, with a next integer index. Let's see how this works. As an example, suppose I allocate an array to hold the values. Let's call this array V. Now notice that our input list has 12 nodes, even though the array has 14 spaces. So in general, we'll let our array pool representation be at least the size of our input list. Now below each node in the input list, I've written an integer. Each integer will be the position of the corresponding value in the V array. For example, the node with value 0 resides in position 13 of the V array. So let's put it there. As another example, let's take the first node whose value is 1. Its position is 12, so let's put it there. What about the second node whose value is 1? Well, that's in position 10, so we've put it there. You could, of course, go on and on, and maybe you should. Smells quizzy. So that's our story for values, but what about the next pointers? For that, let's allocate another array, call it capital N. Now I've made the length the same between N and V so that for every value, there's a corresponding next pointer. Now, although I'm calling these pointers, what I'll put there is not a memory address, but rather the index of the node. For example, look at this node. It points to the node whose position is 9. So its next pointer should also be 9. For the two nodes whose value is 1, the successors are at positions 5 and 8. So we should put those in capital N as well. This array pool representation is critical because it gives us a way to have multiple entry points into the list. To do a list ranking, you still have to walk the list somehow. But at least we'll be able to do things like data parallel operations because we've basically stored everything as arrays.